generate equation for zero order reaction. Zero order reaction means rate is independent of concentration of a reactant. Consider the reaction R gives P. The rate of a reaction R, small letter R, is equal to minus dr by dt, change in concentration of reactant divided by change in time. This equation is known as differential rate equation. Then R is equal to K into molar concentration of reactant R raised to zero. This is rate law expression. This is differential equation. This one is rate law expression. Here, this zero indicates the order of the reaction is zero. That means the reactant, concentration of reactant has no role on the rate of a reaction. These two equations indicates the rate of a same reaction. Now we can easily equate these two equations. That is, R is equal to minus dr by dt is equal to K into molar concentration of R raised to zero. Its value is 1. That is, minus dr by dt is equal to K. Therefore, minus dr is equal to K into dt. Therefore, dr is equal to minus K into dt. On integrating both sides, dr, its integral value is molar concentration of R, which is equal to minus K into integral of dt, its value is t, plus I. I indicate the constant of integration, This is equation 1. Now, we are going to identify the value of I. For that, we have to consider the initial time and initial concentration. Initial time means at time is equal to 0. When time is equal to 0, then concentration R, this indicates the final concentration. Now it changes to initial concentration because time is taken as 0. So R become R0, that is initial concentration. Then R0 is equal to, at time is equal to 0, initial condition R0 is equal to minus K into 0 plus I. We know that this entire portion is changes to 0. Now I is equal to R0. So we can substitute the value of I to the first equation. Now the equation 1 is changes to molar concentration of R is equal to minus KT plus molar concentration of R0. Molar concentration of R is equal to minus KT plus molar concentration of R0. So we can rearrange the equation. R0 minus R, because R0 and R are the same terms, concentration of reactant is equal to KT. Therefore, K is equal to molar concentration of R0 minus molar concentration of R divided by T. So, for a zero order reaction, the rate constant K is equal to initial concentration of the reactant minus final concentration of the reactant divided by T, that is time. If we plot a graph, concentration of reactant against time T, then we get a straight line. The slope of the straight line indicates minus K, and the intercept, this intercept indicates the initial concentration, that is R0. So this is the integrated rate equation for a zero order reaction. zero order reaction, the rate is independent of concentration of reactant. Initially, we have to express the differential equation and the integrated rate law equation. Then we have to equate these two equations. After integration, we will get molar concentration, initial concentration of the reactant minus final concentration is equal to K into time T. From this equation, we can easily denote the rate constant K is equal to R0 minus R divided by T. And this is the graphical representation of zero order reaction, concentration of reactant against time. Then we will get a straight line. The slope of the line indicates minus K, and this intercept gives the initial concentration. Now we are going to discuss about the integrated rate equation for a first order reaction. Consider the reaction R gives P. The rate expression R is equal to minus dR by dt, differential equation. R is equal to K into molar concentration of R raised to 1. Differential rate equation, first one differential rate equation, and this one rate law expression. These two expressions are for the same reaction, and these are expressing the same rate of a reaction. So we can easily equate these two equations. Therefore, R is equal to minus dR by dt is equal to K into molar concentration of R raised to 1. Now we can rearrange the equation. Minus dR by R is equal to rate constant K into dt, which is equal to dR by dt is equal to minus K into dt. R comes to this portion, therefore dR by R is equal to minus K into dt. On integrating both sides, integral dr by r is equal to ln r is equal to integral of minus k dt, minus k in k is a constant, integral of dt is equal to t plus I the constant of integration, equation 1. Now we are going to identify the value of I. For that, we have to consider the initial time 0. When t is equal to 0, the final concentration R become R0. Now the equation changes to, at t is equal to 0, ln R0 is equal to K into 0. All portion completely changes into 0 plus I. That is, the value of I is equal to ln R0. This value can be substituted in equation 1. Now the equation 1 changes into ln R is equal to minus KT plus ln R0. We can rearrange this equation. Ln R0 therefore K is equal to 1 by T ln R0 by R. Applying logarithm, K is equal to 2.303 divided by T log initial concentration of reactant divided by final concentration, or T is equal to 2.303 divided by K log R0 by R. So this is the derivation for a first order reaction, integrated rate expression. This is a very important derivation. For a first order reaction, R gives P. First of all, you have to express the differential rate equation and integrated rate equation. Then you have to equate these two equations. After rearranging the equation, you can easily integrate these two sides, these two equations. Then you will get ln R0 is equal to I. You will get the value of I, substitute value of I in equation 1. Then after rearrangement, the final equation is equal to K is equal to 2.303 divided by T log initial concentration divided by final concentration. In sometimes it can be for the calculation of time, we can rearrange the equation, same equation, then 2.303 divided by K log initial concentration divided by final concentration. So derivation for integrated rate equation for a first order reaction.